Hello and welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to look at using the SimuQuick tab to create hair and cloth physics animation. So the SimuQuick tab is a new inclusion to Rig-GNS, and Rig-GNS is a Blender add-on for rigging and animating Genesis figures from DAS and with animation from Mixamo and DAS Studio. We've had this main Rig-GNS panel, which is used to import and then rig DAS figures with the rigging buttons down here. And there is this Animixer tab for animating the figure with animations from Mixamo or DAS Studio. Also, we have Lip-Meter tab for creating lip sync and facial expressions. And then there is now this latest inclusion to the add-on, which is the SimuQuick tab. Like I said, it's going to help with the creation of hair and cloth physics. Here I have my figure in Blender, which was exported from DAS with all of these accessories, as you can see. So after fully rigging the figure with the add-on, I'm now going to create physics simulation for the hair and the cloth. But before I start with that, let me show you how the cloth and the hair tends to behave when animated without using the SimuQuick physics. Alright, I will expand this Animixer tab and then load a Mixamo animation. And I'll then bind the Mixamo animation to the figure. Now when I play the animation, we should see how rigid the hair appears to be, as though the hair was made of concrete. And hair usually don't behave in this way. And yet the sleeves are not also behaving as it should. And so is the cape and the tail of the skirt. So we're going to look at how to use the SimuQuick tab to make these objects behave as they should. Alright, so now I'm just going to remove the animation and then collapse the Animixer tab and expand SimuQuick tab. Alright. And to start using SimuQuick, I'll first need to select the object I want to simulate. I'm going to start with the hair. So with that selected, I'll go to edit mode and then make a linear selection of edges. What this means is just making an edge loop selection like this. You can see these edges are linearly selected. And a way to make the selection is either by double clicking an edge or pressing the Alt key and then selecting an edge, depending on whether or not you have the emulate 3-button mouse option enabled, which can be found in preferences under the input tab. So when you have this option enabled, you can double click on the edge to loop select. But if you have this disabled, then you will need to hold down Alt and then select the edge. Okay, but I prefer to work with the emulate 3-button mouse option enabled. Another thing worth mentioning is when selecting the linear edges, especially when working with thick objects, objects with volume like this hair, you don't want to have the selection up here. It's advisable to have the selection at a position where the object is likely to make first contact with the figure, which in my case will be the bottom of the hair. One other thing is to make sure the selection spans all the way from the top to the bottom of the object. So you can see my current selection ends slightly below the midpoint here. And we want something that spans from the bottom and then run all the way up here. So I'm going to press the division key on my numpad to go to local view. Now I'm just going to look for a linear selection that is long enough. Okay, let me go to wireframe mode for better viewing of the selection. And yes, you can see this starts all the way from the top here and run down to the bottom. Now I'll go back to solid view, then global view. So with the linear edges selected, the next thing is to generate simu bones here in the SimuQuick tab. This linear selection of edges will just serve as a guide as to where the simu bones will be generated. So now before generating the bones, let us look at these options in the SimuQuick tab. So we have this collision mesh, and then we have bone count and the parent bone. So the collision mesh option just creates a collision mesh for the physics interaction between the object and the figure. But oftentimes when generating simu bones for hair, it's best to leave the collision mesh option disabled. Alright, so the bone count option is used to specify the numbers of bones required for the simulation. But you can see when I click to enable it, it warns that this object already has vertex groups for specifying bone count. So it's basically preventing me from specifying the numbers of bones I need for the simulation. And this is happening because the add-on detected existing vertex group on the mesh that can be used for the simulation, which will then be used to determine the numbers of bones needed. Let me show you this by going to waypoint mode. I will select this sample vertex group tool. Now when I select the spot on the mesh, we should see these weights. We have hip 2, hip 3, hip 4, and these are also vertex groups. We can see that here in the object data properties. So here are the vertex group detected by the add-on, which will be used to create the bones needed for the simulation, hence specifying the total numbers of bones required. But if you need to manually specify the numbers of bones, then you are going to have to remove this group by clicking this minus button here. But I'm not going to do that since this was from DAS, okay? So let me switch back to edit mode. Now the parent bone option is for assigning a parent bone for the generated simu bones. So clicking on this figure is a drop down of parent bones that the generated bones can be parented to. Since the hair object here is going to be controlled by the head bone of the rig, I'm going to leave the parent bone as head. Now, with all that set, I'll go ahead and click the Generate Simu Bones button, and this will take some seconds. And there, you can see we have these bones generated. I'm going to wireframe mode. You should clearly see the generated bones. We have 1, 2, 3, and 4. So now when I press play, we should notice the simulation. I'm going to just import an animation again by going back to the Animixer tab. Here, I still have the fast run animation. So I'll just click the import Mixamo button and bind the animation to the figure and play the animation. All right, so now we should see that this hair is behaving as it should. Okay, so now let's look at these options down here under Simu meshes. This name field here where it says tilt shape contains a list of all Simu meshes in the scene. And the Simu meshes are the actual physics objects which are responsible for controlling the objects in the scene. Currently, I just have this tilt shape which is influencing this hair in the background. Like I said, the actual Simu meshes is currently hidden away in the collection. Let me switch this back to view layer so we can see the mesh. Alright. So you can see this asterisk tail dot shape is hidden here in the Simu collection. And a way to view the Simu mesh in the scene is just by clicking the isolate button down here. Now, this hair mesh, let me pause this animation. So this hair mesh is only copying the behavior of the Simu mesh. You can see the hair mesh is tail dot shape. So this tail dot shape is copying the Simu mesh, which is asterisk tail dot shape, which like I said, is currently hidden in the Simu collection. Now, to view the Simu mesh in the scene, I'm going to toggle on this isolate physics object button. Now we only have the physics object visible in the scene. Here is the main collision object, and this is the Simu mesh which the hair mesh is copying. And when I play the animation, of course you should be able to see that this is obviously the Simu mesh controlling the hair mesh. This isolate physics object can be useful for better viewing of the physics interaction going on. But for now, I'm going to exit this view by clicking the isolate physics object button. Okay, so right beside the isolate button is the edit mesh button. Clicking this button will take us to edit mode where we can edit the Simu mesh. The mesh is currently not visible in the scene and the viewport is in solid view. So I'm going to press Z to go to wireframe mode. Now when I press A to select all, you should see the Simu mesh. And I can now select vertices and make adjustments if there's any need to do that. Okay, so clicking the button again will exit the edit mesh mode. And then of course I'll go back to solid view. Okay, so the last button here is the collide button, and what this button does is simply disable and enable collision for the Simu mesh. When I play the animation, you should notice how the hair mesh is bouncing off the back of the figure because it's colliding with the body. But when I disable this option, you should see how the hair just falls through the figure. Alright, so those are the three toggle buttons for modifying and the Simu mesh. Alright, so down here we have the strength option used for defining the strength of the Simu mesh. If you are familiar with vertex group, you should know that a value of 0.1 is little influence and 1 is full influence. So the strength option works in similar fashion. And this top part of the Simu mesh always have a value of 1, which means very rigid or fixed. While the bottom part of the mesh is whatever value you input in the strength option. So the higher the value, the more rigid the mesh is. So having a value of 0.1 and 10% basically means that this hair mesh constitutes only 10% of the value, which is 0.1. And this value is always assigned from the bottom of the mesh. So if this 10% portion of the mesh is 0.1, then there's going to be an increment in value in the rest of the mesh, making the immediate vertices 0.2, then 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and then the top here is always 1. So if I change this to 50%, then 50% of this hair mesh is now 0.1, then 0.2 will start around here, then 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, all the way to 1 up here. So now when I play the animation with 50% of this mesh having a value of 0.1, you should notice that there is now too much movement in the object. I'm going to increase this value to 0.3. So now 50% of the hair mesh is now 0.3. Now there's going to be a bit less movement. Like I said, the higher the number, the more rigid. Okay, we could try a different value, say 0.2, and then make this 80%. Alright, oftentimes a value between 0.1 and 0.3 and a percentage value between 10 to 20% gives the best result. So here is a comparison between the figure without using SimuQuick and that after using the SimuQuick physics. Okay, so in the next part, we're going to look at creating simulation for this cape, the sleeves, and this tail part of the skirt. Alright, so that is it for this video. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please like the video. And if you're new to this channel and would like to see videos on character animation using Blender and DAW Studio, please subscribe to the channel. Thank you for your time. Till next time.